It's a new month-ish, and I've ordered some stuff from Amazon. Yay, good old Amazon, because of you know, you can never go too wrong with them ordering stuff on Amazon. So I got a few bits, as you say, from Amazon. So I'm going to use a stepping knife and box all this and see what content we have inside. First of which, straight off the bat, as you can see, and that is a Xbox Lite thingy. This is for my room that I'm working on. Then we have ourselves a birthday card towards someone in the future. I thought I'd buy one because it was quite cheap, is another thing. And this is a warehouse deal, as you can see. And this should be, despite it's in a different box. And that is a Hue light bulb. I got this very cheap. And it only does white. And despite a SIM card, because there was a deal, some gold. My Xbox is ready. It's quite ironic wearing a Halo t-shirt because I'll be streaming Halo tonight. But yes, it's all little green, ready to go. In terms of what they're going to announce, I doubt they're going to announce anything decent. But we'll see. Well, it was all right. I would like to play this that Shadow dropped. So yeah, that was it. Thanks for watching. We'll have to see on the later future for the rest of the year and see what they're going to cook up then is, whether for the gaming season for this year. But yeah, it was all right. Just want to say Happy Mario Day to all of yous, even though it's a Sunday. But we've got some nice announcements in terms of the dates of this game and also a particular game, even though I'm more of a Luigi kind of guy, because we've got another date announcement for this certain game as well. So I'm looking forward to these games either way. Depends on when I'm going to pick them up, because I do play on my Nintendo Switch now and again, which is great. And yeah, we just got some really neat announcements. So it's taken a bit of a while, alone. Game Boy games are being added this date as well. Great. Even if it is a Sunday, like I said, I'm mostly going to wear this Mario hat today while I'm streaming, because I'm streaming some Fortnite with some fellow doers. And so I look forward to that, hopefully. But yeah, I'm doing a bonus stream, me way alone, doing whatever this Sunday is another thing. But yeah, Happy Mario Day to all of you. March 10th. Get it? Because March 10th makes Mario. You get the joke. In town today and pick these up for £1 each, and hopefully this will trade in for 15 despite this in general, to hopefully I don't get a strip lady. But yeah, let's go in and trade these in. So I traded them games in for £1 each and got weather credit for it, and I put them towards these two games, the Saboteur and Warrior Land, I should say. I got a parcel from my friend. Let's open it up and see what gubbins we have inside. Get snip snip snip. Oh, what is this? Is it a game? It's a game, despite it's not in its right case, I should say. But it is a certain game that I actually have on disc. And it's got a manual as well, a double-sided manual. But yeah, I wanted this to have an actual cover. And this is the actual cover, but it needs a green case, though. Let's see what cubbins we have inside, content we have inside. And we have... some bits and bobs. Now, first of which, and that is, well, one of the cards that my friend duelled me with and left this behind, and also he ordered this on eBay for me also, and finally that he ordered on eBay, and some bits and bobs for my PSP, one of my broken PSP that I'm going to fix up. I thought I'd do an update on my Yu-Gi-Oh stuff, even though that I got this for Christmas, last Christmas, which is great, even though it's mostly to display than it is weather. And I forgot to show you on the last bit of the last update that I got this in the car boot sale for 50p, and I got that from Manchester's, all different topic. But yeah, I'm trying to squeeze as much as I can because of them. It is a hell of a lot of stuff, and then he's using some black tack or grey tack or whatever. As you can see, I replaced them all because I used to use white tack and now I use grey tack, and it looks nicer with the grey tack. Even though there is a new tin going to be coming out, and most of the other tins are behind there, but I tried to squeeze everything in. But there is a new tin coming out, so I don't think I'm going to squeeze that in. Even though the case though is down there, because I can't fit it with all the other stuff, because it'll be too heavy, it's all different thing. since I have a certain card on me, as you can see, because I'm going to order a new PC parts at some point. But since it's a particular day, and my friends are aware that I've got a certain card on me, I thought we'd do a little bit of a prank, I should say, today. You know, I know a bit late, despite the time. But yeah, let's do this. I'm going to prank him. See if how he responds. Oh, he's seen it. Oh, he's replying. What is he saying? Our survey says, I don't know if he realises it's April Fool's. Well, if he doesn't reply then, realising, then I guess April Fool's, I guess.
I was unsure to share this, but I thought I'd share it anyways, and that is, I've been to a charity shop and I got all these for £1 each. Yes. And there are some fails, though, sadly. Like this Minecraft, for example. Despite to me, it comes in a nice case. And sadly, though, the disc, though, is a bit... Then it is some other games, like Grand Theft Auto 5, but only comes with a play disc, sadly. And I'm going to keep these particular games, because I didn't realise that Overlord is actually a backwards compatible game. So that's neat. And this is a £15 game that I got for £1, which is not bad. And Call of Duty, because I feel like taking a Call of Duty. And yeah, they have installed. As you can see, I've got Left 4 Dead installed. I've got that game installed. And I've got Overlord installed. So the discs are working fine. So hopefully CEX will take these lot. And that's like £30 worth of credit, this is.
It's here. It's finally here. Even though, funny which, the guy at that gave me it, I had to say my last name. I had to say my friend's last name to be able to... what's your last name? Definitely not my last name, but anyways. So we're going to unbox this today and see what gubbins we have. Despite this is from Scan, you know, the good old, you know... Was it saying that? Let's just say... Anyways, yeah, I'm going to unbox it. Right, I did this with the stabby knife and see what content we have inside. Oh, it's nicely bubble wrapped. That's good. Good, that's handy. Is there an invoice? No, I don't think there's an invoice. Oh, wait, I think there is something. Oh, that's one of the parts. The CPU. And the motherboard. The power supply and the RAM. Since I got certain games to add to the Xbox Zone library, it's going up to nearly almost the rim, as you can see by the bottom there, than is the top there and all that. So I might have to convert my Xbox 360 games. Do keep in mind, these are the Xbox 360 games that are backwards compatible on Xbox One. And I might have to do this method to this method, so we'll have to like change it up a bit. I know it's not the best, despite I know people like to have it vertically, which I prefer things vertically, as you can see. But it's a protocol that I have to do in terms of running out of space. But yeah, at least I've got some space left if I end up getting weather for Xbox One or Xbox 360 in general when it comes to this lot. But yeah, it's just something I have to do with my collection. Mm-hmm. Sorry for the minor noise, but yeah, I picked up a Facebook Marketplace pickup. Got this bundle for £20, and I met him in a place called Aldi. But yeah, I picked up this bundle mainly because I wanted to get a copy of Street Fighter X Tekken, because that's like a £12 game in CEX. And this controller alone is like a £25 controller, despite it doesn't have the... much bit, you know, I could replace whatever bits, but it's better than my other one that I have, because this is quite mint, I should say. But yeah, most of it is really in good condition. I could trade in, like, you know, this for around £5, of course, and this for £3. I did do my research either way, but yeah, I mostly got it for that, and this controller as well. But yeah, and a nice bundle. But yeah, this was like £20 in total, which is not bad. It was going to go for £25, but I ended up getting it for around £20 instead. So yeah, I'm going to cover this up because it is quite rainy today, and then hit the bus home, I should say. Since the car boot was a bit meh today, I ended up getting this from the Facebook Marketplace for £15. It comes with three different strips, alone. That's hard to carry, is another thing. I know what you're thinking. Stephen, they're huge. Well, I bet you're wondering, where are you going to put these? Well, Michael for sure. Don't know where to put him. Maybe in the loft. him now, he can go in the game, get the Xbox game room, and you, Trevor, my friend, is going to go there. But Saturday, we'll have to move the Blu-rays over there, and he's making space for good old Trevor.
There, here's a picture.
Well, I'm moving, you know, like I said, that to there, and it's all there, and it's there. Now for you, Buster, upstairs.
There we go. That's that sorted.
Goes well the room, I should say, then he's finishing up this room. It's all different topic.
Oh. The postman has been, then it came from Amazon, sorry for the wettest box, but it came. It came, and thank you, Josh, for this, for towards this, and that is Zelda and Chill on vinyl. Yes, Zelda and Chill on vinyl. And this came from the US of A, is another thing. Just put in a good old plastic sleeve to protect it, of course, even though that the record is quite good by the looks of it. So you're going to take it out of its sleeve, plonk it on, and play a bit of it. Not too much, because I'm unsure about copyright claims, and it is... you can credit the person if you wanted to, but I think it's loyalty-free in a bit. Yeah, it's got that lo-fi, chill kind of beats. I love it. I love the soundtrack. Thank you again, Josh, for towards this.